sucker punch a child.
Can I just say real quick? I just called because we got a Kickstarter going for Cal.
Oh.
And I was hoping your viewers out there could give some money.
I would love to help. For Cal. But I just got released from prison. So I do not have any
well,
money.
Well, statistically, that was bound to happen now, wasn't it?
Well,
hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Eskwilax Hour. Friday, I don't even know the date, but Eskwilax Hour, oh, it's the 15th.
Yeah.
And today we have our special guest, Israel. He's going to be painting for us. You want to say, you're from Venice, right? You live
yeah.
in Venice?
I live in Venice,
in Los Angeles.
Yeah, so we're just gonna try to do a quick. I'm gonna paint my model Shadia today, so she's changing, she's getting ready.
Okay. I'm just gonna keep talking, and he's gonna start setting up right here in the background for you guys. So you're gonna go ahead and do that,
yeah.
And I'll just keep talking to the audience. All right, guys. Yeah, like I was saying, it's Friday, and it's been a windy week. It's weird. So the Eskwilax Hour, you know, where we bring you all the news from the streets, if we have any of them, bring you live artists, all sorts of artistic and creative ideas that we can bring out here from local artists. We've had artists from, you know, LA, Long Beach, I think Mascota, Mexico, you know, Yeyo, he came last time, and with Chucky and Efren Luna, you know, everybody, if you guys are watching, what's up? So in the meantime, you know, Israel, he paints, is it oil, right?
Yeah, oil. You saw it today.
All right. So, yeah, keep going. So he's gonna paint with oil. He's gonna have about 40 minutes, and he's gonna split it in two sections, two 20-minute sections, with his model Shadia, right?
Yeah,
Shadia. And I'm guessing she's gonna stand here, or she's gonna be sitting down on her guest couch, whichever Israel chooses right now. As soon as she comes on.
Can I move this?
Yeah, yeah. I can help you.
No, it's
fine. You're not staying this one?
Huh? Oh. Yeah.
All right, guys, so we're still kind of setting up. Sorry about our running a little bit late. All that traffic. It's always that traffic. Everybody gets stuck. Either if they're coming from West LA, Long Beach, I don't know, Montebello. Even Montebello is like 5 minutes from here and you're still getting stuck. So as you can see his setup right here, he has his easel, his brushes on this side, fresh, nice, clean canvas that he's gonna work on for us today. I personally haven't used oil before. I tried it once. It had a really like strong smell to it, so you know, that wasn't really something that it didn't attract me that much. I was more into acrylic, because acrylic, you can use it indoors. You can use it, it's quicker, it dries quicker. Whereas oil, I heard that you can leave it and, I don't know, like 2-3 days, it'll still be wet. It's good in a way where you can keep using it and mixing it. But like acrylic, where it's like, I don't know, half an hour later, acrylic's already dry and you keep adding to it quicker. I guess because of my graffiti background, I'm more used to doing things faster and just getting it done. And even here, you know, I have an hour sometimes and where I do my spray painting, but even that I feel is not fast enough just because it doesn't mix. So right now we're still, he's not come on right now, we're waiting. As you guys know, we have the new chat where you can go on dronebox.com, and then you, of course you have to get an account, and then you can basically, we have a screen right on this side, on my left side, and like the comments will come on. If anybody's watching right now that's been on the show, you guys can always shout us out. And so far I think it's either frozen or it's not up and running yet, but nobody's talking to me, so. Yeah. All right. So you guys can't see me now, but you can see that Israel is still setting up his easel, making sure it's at the right angle, just the perfect setup, because we don't have that much time, but it still has to be done right.
What, me?
See you.
All right, guys. So we have a guest for the audience. It's Hector, a friend of mine. He's gonna come in. Oh, you guys see, we had a little trouble right here. Some paper hanging on the light. Cool. So yeah, again, sorry for the late start. I'm getting blinded. Ah. Okay. Huh?
So
you want to tell us a little bit about your palette, or?
Yeah, basically, when I paint, since right now we only have, 45 minutes roughly. So I'm going to do just a monochromatic painting today. I'm going to use what it's called a
kind of combination of, it's called rubber technique. So what I'm gonna do first is just, we're starting with a white canvas. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just try to get rid of this white or perhaps leave part of it. So I don't really know yet because when the model comes and sets there, so then I can see if I'm gonna leave some of the white or, you know, if I'm gonna just cover the whole canvas. So it's one of those things that you have to think about it before you do, because like, I mean, before you start painting, because my process, it's really, most of the time I paint what I see. So, you know, I can't just start. So I have to have a reference, or in this case, you know, we're gonna use the model is gonna pose for me. So until she's there, then I can figure out what to do with this. So as far as like technique, it's really simple. I'm just gonna use one color, a burnt umber, oil paint. So, you know, it's in a way, it's more like drawing, because, you know, I'm not gonna deal with colors, even though I brought my palette here. But this I use when I have more time, when I pay at the studio, or, you know, I have like a 3-hour pause. So, you know, then decide to do, using this color. But in this case, you know, it said time is limited. So we're gonna try to just do what we can in those 40 minutes, just using one color, you know, more like drawing. So.
So you guys can see, he's more professional than me, you know, where I just whip up my spray cans and just kind of go and throw them on there. Where he has, like you say, he's going to use, you said umber? Is that what it's called?
Burnt umber. It's a color.
Burnt umber. Yeah. That's like the one color. Single color he's going to use because of the time frame that we have today.
So I don't really have
I don't really have a rule to paint, really. I'm use anything. There's no, like, I don't use any specific brand brush or anything. I just use what I can, you know. I even use like this Viva paper towel for my light. So really, whatever makes the job, you know, like cheap brushes. So this is kind of like a house paint brush. I'm probably gonna use this because, you know, I'm gonna move quicker. So it's.
And house paint, I mean, house brush, you mean you could just get it like at Home Depot, right?
Yeah. Simple. Honestly, I mean, the way I paint, it's very loose and it's just whatever I can use. It's just I don't use my hands. Some people like using arm for oil. It's not very safe, so I try to avoid that. I have a nice set of brushes that I can just select. When I mean nice, I'm just saying like it's not the brand, but just like it holds the shape and stuff like that. So I just look for what makes the job ready. That's what I'm looking for.
Okay. So whenever you guys are ready.
Ready?
Okay. Bye.
Come on,
Shadia.
Shadia.
Ah, down, that's fine. Yeah.
And shoes?
No shoes.
But igual está la manta, so.
No, I'm gonna pose it here.
Okay, on the couch? Oh, where do you want?
Yeah, it's gonna be sitting on. I'll fix it so it's.
All right.
So I'm picturing the pose as I'm doing this. I already kind of know what I want in my head.
Yeah. Let me just see my cameras.
Can you guys use this?
Yeah, but we have to put something in the bottom.
Oh, okay, that's fine. Actually,
so he's getting Shadia ready for the pose where he's gonna start painting, and I'm just gonna shut up. All right, I know you guys want me to. Just setting up the cameras also. Thank you. All right, guys. So he's basically, he has to set up really well. So just so he has the right pose.
Yeah.
Remember, he's a pro.
Yeah, I'm figuring out.
Okay, let me just check the other one. There you go. You guys can get up an HD close up. Okay. As you guys can see, this isn't an easy process. You guys can still hear me, but
yes.
Whoops. There we go. I just put the big screen so you guys can see the whole thing for now. And as I said, my friend's over here. He's gonna say hi to the camera. Yeah, he doesn't have a mic on, so he's just gonna wave at you guys. So that's the audience over there.
Where's the camera? Right here.
Just say hi.
Hi, how are you? Here with my friend Efren Martinez at the Eskwilax Hour.
So we don't want to be too. What do you call it? We don't want to make a lot of noise. So he's gonna start now. And I'm just gonna be in the audience, chilling.
It's okay. We talk as we go, right?
You sure? Yeah. No, I didn't wanna be like, you know.
No, that's fine. We could just. I don't know if it's okay for you. I don't mind. It's good.
It's just usually when we work, you know, I've been working with Shadia for a while. So she's a great model. She's one of the best models I know. So she's really good at this. So we're just trying to figuring out the pose. Always take time, you know.
Yeah.
Because you want. You know, it's not like just like come and you wanna set up something nice. Basically, what I look for, I try to set a pose so it has like nice shapes, nice kind of like straight lines, so that I can use that in drawing. It's you know, it's very important to you know, just to compose the design. So it's very important in the first place just to set up a good pose. Okay.
Yeah.
And that's why, you know, we spend
some time. No, I understand. You're a pro. You know, you. This is what he does, so.
Okay.
This is the first time we've had live models.
Live models? So.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be cool.
Everybody's going to like it.
Yeah, let's see what happens. So, yeah, you can ask, I don't know, if you want to ask questions as I go. If you guys have a question for anything, just go ahead.
Well, for right
this
now?
This is the color I'm going to use. Okay, uh-huh. So I'll just put enough color here. Okay, there you go. That's enough. I don't know, you guys can see I have some white here, but that was just from my previous painting. I'm not going to use white in this case, so I'm just going to use like a kneaded eraser later to pull my light if I need to.
Okay,
so before I start, you know, there's three steps that I try to kind of follow when I paint. I always look at the model, analyze the pose, and then start painting, basically. So, you know, I'm visually, so I'm right-handed, so I always pose the model to the left. So that way, you know, I can just transfer, like, what I see onto the canvas right there.
Oh, you see, okay? That's something I would have never
So, because
noticed.
If you're right-handed, and if you pose the model here to me, it's harder. You know, my head just been looking there, but I can't really relate, so I'll be doing this the whole time. But if I have the model here, you know, I'm looking at the canvas back and forth, so that's easy. Okay.
Wow.
So
yeah. That's really interesting.
Posing the camera this way also like captures everything that I'm gonna do. Okay. So we're gonna when we paint live, we You know, we take, you know, just set the pause for 20, 25 minutes max. Okay, and then we give the model the break, a break every time, every 25 minutes. So we, and we set up kind of like the timer so we know we don't, you know, we don't go over.
Okay.
You know, the model need a break. You know, they're nice to pause for us. So, you know, we gotta just kind of, also I need a break, you know, just to kind of see what I'm doing there.
So, definitely. Yeah. All right. So yeah, if you wanna go ahead, I'll just let you for now and then I'll come in a few minutes again. Mira, eso está mal.
The very first thing that I put here, I'm just kind of visualizing how I'm going to use this entire canvas here, entire surface, to compose the pose, okay? So just approximately that's where the hip's going to be here.
And this, I don't in the way.
Yeah, it's fine. It's okay. So I'm just, yeah, that's fine. So this is just figuring out where everything is gonna go. She's got this nice, really dark hair, so I'm just gonna put some dark here. When we paint the figure, we always try to simplify it as much as we can. You know, it's not so much about copying everything what's there, but really, it's rather just looking at the pose and figuring out what's the best way to capture what you see without copying everything. Okay. We call it abstract the figure, which means, you know, I'm not looking at any detail right now. I'm more interested in just capturing the big shapes that I see that's going to make the figure. Okay, so, and I put just this light wash of color over the camera just to get the average value for the skin color. And I'm probably, you know, I'm going to leave the canvas, this whole section white. Right now I have that option, so you know it's going to give me you know, nice abstract shapes here when I finish. So I develop, you know, I'm going to go back here and try to develop the shape of the head and then leave probably a lot of this unfinished, which personally I like that look in a painting. I especially like paintings that are has these qualities, you know, where you see part of it already unfinished and then you have a focal point. So, and that's really what attracts me when I paint. And that's what I look for. See, now I'm just using, like, this is just all raw, you know, my old t-shirt and stuff. So that makes it, yeah, it's there's nothing, it's nothing special. It's really, right now, just simple brush. It's a big brush, you know, just to get this. So I'm just trying to map out like these big shapes. Okay. But I don't know if you guys can kind of see already, like, you know, the head is going to be here. I already know that. So this is the back of the model here. And when I squint down, this is something we do when we paint, you know, and if there's something that's confusing, we look at the subject and you squint down your eyes. So anything that's dark becomes darker. Anything that's light becomes lighter. So we use this way of kind of seeing to simplify what we see. Okay, now I'm gonna switch to a smaller brush here. Okay, then do some line work. And start getting into smaller sections. So it's always like capturing the biggest shape, and then we go back and start making it more specific. Okay, so now I can see her hairline here. It's very easy to see that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just gonna make this value a little bit lighter. So, and then it's also when we plan this a session, you know, it's the same with my other session. I always like kind of ask the model what to bring, what to wear. So, you know, we pretty much know ahead of time what we need for every session. So. I like to use this kind of stick right here just to, you know, when I go back to the head, just this allows me like to, you know, just to really control the lines that I'm gonna draw here. So if I do this, it's like, you know, sometimes it shakes and it's kind of hard to, you know, just to put the lines you want. But if you do this, you know, you rest your hand over this, it, you know, you can almost write with the brush and, you know, it's pretty accurate, whatever you're doing there. Okay, good.
China.
This is where I spend a lot of time. You know, it's very important for me to develop, a good indication of the head, because everything else that I'm going to do after this point, it's going to depend on that specific part of the body. So, you know, sometimes when I plan my painting, I spend a lot of time figuring out the position, okay? It's really important for me to get a good indication there. Okay, so I don't know if you can see kind of what I'm doing a little bit there, if it shows.
Yeah, they can see it.
It's really, you know, really, I'm just kind of trying to hit some landmarks here on the face where everything is going to go. So the process is more about, you know, fixing this drawing as I go here. Not so much trying to finish every part of it, but, you know, trying to kind of see, you know, that same idea that I start with, you know, keep that idea through the end, you know, the big shape that's going to make the the head. Okay, so, you know, it's kind of like sculpture, you know, we start with blocks and then we slowly start to shape it up into smaller sections. So that's all I'm doing at this stage. It's not so much about a drawing, it's more about feeding out. It's more like positioning things in place, really, okay? So I use a lot of straight lines in my paintings, drawings, okay?
Set up the timer,
and I like to, you know, from time to time, just kind of check the, you know, the timer, just to see, especially if we have like a limited time. So I'm trying to try to get as much as I can in the time we have. So that's why it's important for, you know, I always, you know, check the time.
And I think you guys could hear me, but you guys can always find Israel's artwork on Instagram. That's where you can, Israel Martinez Art, that's where you guys can find him. A lot of his artwork's for sale, and in a lot of galleries also. So, just throwing that out there in case we run out of time later.
You can always see nicer stuff, you know, like more finished. But this is actually, in a way, you know, it's kind of nice. I personally like seeing other artists work, like in the beginning stage, just to see how the painting or how the drawing develops. You know, it's because a lot of times you don't get to see that often. You know, you see the final product, like really refined paintings. But for a student or for someone who's interested in painting, I think it's very important to see how, you know, from the beginning. So
yeah, that's true. So it's been like 20 minutes now, almost. So he's about to give the model a break because it is strenuous in a way to be sitting, like, you know, in one position for a while. You want to go ahead?
So what I just did right there, I went up there to mark the model foot on the floor. That's how we're able to, you know, bring the model back to the same pose later. So when we give it a break, we, you know, we kind of, you know, then we go back to the same pose. So the model just...
Like, it's not in the wrong place, right?
Yeah, so when she comes back, she just puts the foot there, and, you know, between the tape, and she goes back to the same pose. So.
Okay. So we're gonna take a break for like 5 minutes and then go back and resume this session. Okay.
So as he takes his break, again, you can always find him on Facebook. You can find him on Instagram. He has really fine art, and he has he also teaches some classes like in like mainly in West LA area. Where is that you're at right now?
Well, it's right now I'm just doing a lot of mostly like a lot of private classes, a lot of groups. So, and I'm independent, so you know, which means if anybody's interested in drawing, you know, just I just get a space and I go and teach people. That's what I'm doing right now. I used to work for like 3 different art schools professionally for 7 years, and now I'm just doing independent work. I just do commission work for clients and do my paintings, do my own classes. And we right now currently we have some classes running in El Segundo. It's like a gallery. That's what I'm doing right now. That's like the new spot, so it's open. Anybody can go see. It's on, you know, you can find it on Facebook. It's a it's called Art Space. So it's called Art Space El Segundo.
Yeah.
So that's where we are. Okay. I'm doing some classes there for all level, pretty much. So
you guys heard that? It's all level, beginner, intermediate.
Yeah. You can always like the best, you know, because I'm constantly moving like from just one place to another. You know, I you know, I go to like different places. So the best way to find me is through my email. You know, my email is ismartinez, MARTINEZ 78@gmail.com, or just request me on Facebook, Israel Martinez Art. I'll make sure you put art there, okay? So that's why you want to find me. Yeah. Instagram is the same, it's just like the country, Israel Martinez Art, and you'll see a lot of what I'm doing here. So if you can see this, a lot of what you see there, it's I started the same way, really. You know, the process is always like, when I start the figure, I always start with the head, okay? And no matter, even if I don't see the head, a lot of time I paint the back view, but you know, I still, you know, start, you know, where in the head is. Because based on this particular shape now, you can kind of see, you know, where I'm going with this. It's still very, very raw, very abstract, but you know, it's, I can see, you know, I can see where I'm going with this, so. Kind of mentally,
yeah.
You know, even.
I remember I took a class with his like one time, but I didn't know, I never done figure drawing before, so, or painting. So I thought it would work the way I know how to do it, where it's just like circles and filling in here and there. So, but now that I'm seeing it and he's explaining it, that he starts it as an abstract painting, you know, it makes more sense now, rather than, you know, the way I was doing it was just trying to kind of figure it out as I went.
Yeah. The thing is though, like working it this way, it because in when you paint, you want to just create a nice design, so you have a frame, right? It's like watching a movie. So you know, it's like you're composing in the frame. When you take photo, you're still doing the same thing. You have the square. So how do you take advantage? How do you use a square? Sometimes you do like a vertical composition, sometimes you do like a horizontal composition. So from the beginning, when you see your reference, you already know like whether you're going to use like a vertical composition or horizontal composition.
Yeah.
Because here, imagine, you know, like for this one, if I put like, let's say like a small head right there, then I'm already starting with like a bad composition because I'm going to end up with a lot of empty space here. So, okay. So that's really what I do is just like kind of, that's why also like, I don't know if you guys notice, I step back, I do a couple strokes, and because this way, if I'm standing all the way here, I can see the model and I can see the canvas. So it's very easy that way. Right now it's very, very open, oil paint, it's a very forgiving media, it's like charcoal. So any mistake, it stays open for so long, you know, stays wet. So there is, you know, if you do something, like if you, let's say if you make a dark mark where you don't want it, just go back and erase it. And you know, it's a very fun medium. In my opinion, it's the best medium to learn how to paint. So it's because it's like stays wet. Some people think acrylic, but acrylic, it's good.
That's mirror,
but because the fact that it dries so quick, you know, it doesn't allow you to play around with the edges or erasing. This is more, you almost gonna forget about the paint part. So you're just like trying to solve problems with the oil paint. You know, the only thing like some people don't like it because, you know, it involves like you can't mix it with water. Yeah. Okay, that's the only thing. But aside from that,
what do you have in there?
It's a liquid. It's called Gamsol. It's made by Gamlin, and I like using that. It doesn't smell, and it's good for painting. I mean, there's a lot of different products out there now. So let's try to keep it simple.
Yeah. Okay. And, you guys gonna.
Yeah, let's do this last one. See how far we can go.
Okay. So there's gonna be like a few minutes left once we start on this one. So basically, right now Israel's just gonna keep going until, you know, the show is over,
which is another 15, 20 minutes.
Es que esa madre lo apagaron, pero está bien oscuro.
I use this is just Q-tips, okay? So I just, in case, you know, I probably too small to see in the camera, but that's how I make, if I want to make this area dark lighter, I can just go over that, or I can use the same idea here to push, slide the volume here to make that darker. So it's a very simple technique. I'm just using three brushes, Q-tips, and that's it.
So you don't always have to use brushes, right? You can use
use whatever works, really, you know?
Yeah.
This is, I just like this technique. It's just such a nice and easy way to learn, you know, just one color. For any beginner interested in doing oil, I recommend that because, you know, you don't have to buy a lot of colors. It's more about learning your values and, you know, learning like the brush strokes and stuff. So in that sense, it's, you know, it's great. So
last thing here for what I'm using. I also use kneaded eraser for my lights. Remember, like earlier, I mentioned something about I don't use white because, you know, I'm not using white paint here. This is just a kneaded eraser you guys can get at any art store. Okay, so use a piece. They come in three different sizes. I'm sorry. So, yeah, this is just a kneaded eraser, I'm using. So I'm just going to give you guys an example here. You take a piece. I'm going to just, I don't know if you can see the highlight right there, right in the back, or like the part of the ear right there. So I use a piece of kneaded eraser to indicate that. Okay. There, right? So, yeah. It's a good example there. Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. That's why I didn't want to interrupt you. Son cinco más. Cinco más, te digo. Sí. Yeah.